Well, everybody thinks there's some magic formula that they have to follow, and you know, the reality is there isn't a magic formula, Ryan. If we had a magic marketing formula, then every book that got published would be a bestseller, but that doesn't happen. I love what Michael Korda wrote in his book, Making the List, about, you know, how it's really just, it's basically a gamble for every publisher, whether a traditional publisher or whether a self-publisher, as to how that book is going to sell and how it's going to really strike the audience out there. I mean, this book, if you don't have that book by Michael Korda, I love it. It's on my shelf, called Making the List. And what he does, he analyzes the bestseller list for the last century. And, you know, you look at that list, there's just a bunch of weird stuff on there. I mean, why? There's a couple of books about how to play canasta, you know, that made the bestseller list in the 50s. I mean, how did that get on the list? Well, it got on the list because canasta swept the nation and everybody went out there to buy a book about figuring out how to play that card game, you know? So, you know, there's just no rhyme or reason about how this stuff happens, but it's a matter of knocking on enough doors out there until the right door opens for your book and you're able to tap into your audience. So it takes work. And I don't care who publishes your book these days, that's the kind of effort that it takes to find success.
Yeah, I remember something that just blew my mind was listening to how Jack Canfield told how M. Scott Peck, is it? The Road Less Traveled?
Yes.
And how much he was doing to promote his own book. I think he said he was on multiple interviews a day for several years, and then after that, he kept up an interview a day for another 2 or 3 years. Just work is really an underlying principle to all of this, for sure.